There isn't much doubt that the economy is the big driver in the 2012 election cycle. But Republicans vying for the top spot on the GOP ticket are using another issue to take their shots at the current frontrunner. Correspondent Doug McKelway has the story.
With John Huntsman set officially to enter the Republican race tomorrow, his campaign has been running this teaser web video to grab much-needed attention. Polls show him ranking dead last. Meanwhile, others in the Republican field sought their own place in the spotlight by attacking frontrunner Mitt Romney's credentials as a social conservative.
It is not government that gives us the right to life. It is God, our Creator, who gives us the right to life.
On Friday, five in the Republican field, including Bachman, Tim Pawlenty, Rick Santorum, Newt Gingrich, and Ron Paul, signed the Susan B. Anthony List Pro-Life Pledge. That pledge calls on signers to support only judicial nominees who are pro-life, to select pro-life cabinet members, to stop taxpayer funding of abortions, and to support a bill that would ban abortions after 20 weeks of pregnancy. Businessman Herman Cain refused to sign it, citing congressional jurisdiction over abortion funding. And frontrunner Mitt Romney did not sign it either, leading to this broadside from rival Bachman, quote, "The excuses for not signing clearly continue the doubts about his leadership and commitment to ending the practice of abortion, particularly for a candidate who ran as pro-choice for the Senate and governorship of Massachusetts," end quote. A senior advisor to Romney today defended the governor's refusal to sign the pledge while touting his pro-life credentials.
He's strongly pro-life. He just affirmed again, and it's on our website, a whole array of pro-life positions went further, I think, than the pledge went. But he doesn't want to say he's disqualified from considering people who may not agree with him on everything on that issue for a job like FBI director.
Some say that Romney's muted response to the attacks may be a wise strategy so early in the campaign season.
I think it's something that is not going to be that much on the minds of the Republican voters or voters in November 2012. I think it's all going to be about the economy.
One indication of Republican voters' concern, Ron Paul's victory at the Republican Leadership Conference's straw poll this weekend, where his pledge of limited government and fiscal responsibility clearly resonated.
At the same time, this flurry of attacks on Romney by his rivals is likely to curry favor among another important constituency, the National Right to Life organization, which begins its four-day convention in Jacksonville, Florida this Thursday. Much of its agenda is focused on getting out the vote.